Now let's look at the case of multi-tone modulation. So we had our AM signal as AC 1 plus KA MT cos 2 pi FCT. Now let's put MT is equal to AM 1 cos 2 pi FM 1T plus AM 2 cos 2 pi FM 2T. So you can see there are two frequency components. Usually when you have more than one frequency component, we'll call it multi-tone. Here we have two frequency components. These two frequencies are not equal to each other. That is why I have written FF1 and FM2. Their amplitude is AM1, AM2. It can be same. The amplitude can be same, but the frequency is different. Okay. So this is your message signal now. If you will put here MT is equal to this expression, you will get your AM signal as AC1 plus KA AM1 cos 2 pi FM1T plus KA AM2 cos 2 pi FM2T into cos 2 pi FCT, where KA AM1 is your mu1 and KA AM2 is your mu2. Okay. If you will expand this expression, you will get AC cos 2 pi FCT, AC mu1 divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM1T plus AC mu1 divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM1T plus AC mu2 divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM2T plus AC mu2 divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM2T. So this is your expanded expression. So once you apply cos A cos B with these guys, you will get these two terms. You apply cos A cos B with this, you will get these two terms, and you multiply cos signal, you will get this term. So this is your carrier part, this is your USB 1, this is your LSB 1, this is your USB 2, this is your LSB 2. Okay, so that is how the signal will look like when you will have multi-tones. Okay, so it's not like you can only have two, you can have other terms as well. As right now I am showing it with two frequency components, so accordingly the expression will expand. Okay, let's look at the spectrum of multi-tone modulation. So assume FM2 is greater than FM1 and mu2 is greater than mu1. It will be easier to show you the spectrum with this condition. So you can see this is your zero frequency and this is your frequency axis. This is your carrier AC divided by 2 at FC frequency. This is AC mu1 divided by 4 and AC mu1 divided by 4 at FC minus F1 and FC plus F1. And then you have AC mu2 divided by 4, AC mu2 divided by 4 at FC minus F2 and FC plus FM2. FM2. Okay. So you can see because FM2 is greater than FM1, that is why M2 part is coming later. And you can see the amplitude, since mu2 is greater than mu1, that is why this amplitude is greater than this amplitude. So it is easier to show. Okay. Now one thing I want to mention here is this is the positive part. The same thing, same whole signal will be in negative part as well. But we are interested in positive part because we are looking for bandwidth. So you can see the bandwidth is from this point to this point, which is FC plus FM2 minus FC minus FM2, which comes out to be 2 into FM2, which is 2 into Fmax. So you can say the bandwidth of the multi-mode, multi-tone modulation modulated signal will be 2 into highest frequency of message signal. Okay, so this is the point you can extract from this. It is helpful. So you have 4 or 5 frequency components in message signal, then you choose the highest one, highest frequency, and you multiply with 2. That will be the bandwidth of multi-tone modulated signal. Okay, now let's look at the power of multi-tone modulated signal. So we know total power is equal to carrier power plus sideband power. We can write sideband power as upper sideband plus lower sideband power, and PC as it is. This can also be written as PC plus PUSB1 plus PUSB2 plus PLSB1 plus PLSB2. Now PC is AC square divided by 2R, which is same as before. Now PUSB1 is equal to PLSB1 is equal to AC square mu1 square divided by 8R, and PUSB2 is equal to PLSB2 is equal to AC square mu2 square divided by 8R. So this you can calculate from the spectrum amplitude square divided by 2R. So that is what I did. Then if you plug these three values here, so you will get AC square divided by 2R plus AC square mu 1 square divided by 4R, since these two have same power. Similarly, AC square mu 2 square divided by 4R, these two have same power, that is y into 2. Now if you take out AC square divided by 2R common, you will get 1 plus mu 1 square plus mu 2 square divided by whole 2. And now if you compare, you have PT is equal to PC 1 plus mu T square divided by 2. PC is your same, this is your total power. Now mu has a new term, that is total modulation index mu T, that is equal to under root mu 1 square plus mu 2 square. So you can see there is a change in the power of the multi-tone modulated signal, and that is because of the change in the modulation index. So now you don't have mu 1 or mu 2, you have under root mu 1 square plus mu 2 square. Okay, so this will be your new modulated index, and you plug the value, you get the total power. And similarly, you can calculate the multiply inside the PC. So PC will be your carrier power, and PC into mu 2 square divided by 2 will be your sideband power. Let's look at an example. It is given that an unmodulated AM power is given by 10 kilowatt. When the carrier is modulated by first message signal, AM power is increased to 13.5 kilowatt. Find an AM power if the carrier is simultaneously modulated by second message signal with 60% of modulation. So by the first line, you can see unmodulated power means mu was equal to 0. So this was your carrier as well as total power. Now when the carrier got modulated by first message signal, the total power increased to 13.5 kilowatt. Now in this case, you can understand carrier power is 10 kilowatt and total power is 13.5 kilowatt when the carrier is modulated by first signal. So I use the formula PT is equal to PC 1 plus mu 1 square divided by 2, where PC is your 10 kilowatt, PT is your 13.5 kilowatt and mu 1 when it is modulated by first carrier signal. So from here, if you will plug the value, you can get the value of mu 1 as under root 0.7. Now in the next line, we have to find the AM power when the carrier is simultaneously modulated by second message signal. So we saw the formula for this simultaneously modulation, that is PT is equal to PC 1 plus mu T square divided by 2, where mu T square is equal to mu 1 square plus mu 2 square. Okay, so mu 1 you have calculated here, mu 2 is given here, 60%. So you can calculate mu T square is equal to 0.7 plus 0.36, that comes out to be 1.06. So if you plug the value of mu T and PC will be same, 10 kilowatt, you will get 15.3 kilowatt as your AM power when the carrier is modulated simultaneously by both the signals, message 1 and message 2. Okay, so this will be your answer. Let's look at next example. It is given that AM current is given by 10 ampere corresponding to the carrier is modulated by first signal, first message signal with 40% of modulation. When the carrier is simultaneously modulated by second message signal, AM current increased to 10.5 ampere. Find percentage of modulation due to second message signal. So from the first line, you can see your total AM current is given when it is modulated by first message signal with mu is equal to 40%. So if you will apply the formula for current relation, IT1 is given, mu1 is given, you can calculate IC1. Mu1 is 0.4, IT1 is 10 ampere. So IC can be calculated from this as 9.62 ampere. Now from the second line, you can see when the carrier is simultaneously modulated, so you can apply the current relation with mu T. Okay, so here you can see IT is increased to 10.5 ampere, so 10.5 I have taken. IC1 you can take from here 9.622 under root 1 plus mu 1 square plus mu 2 square divided by 2, where mu 1 is given and mu 2 you have to find. So when you plug the equation mu 1, plug the values 9.622 here and 0.40 at the place of mu 1, you can calculate mu 2, that is 0.47. Okay. Okay, let's look at another example. It is given an AM signal given by ST equal to 20 plus 12 cos 2 pi 10 to the power 40 plus 16 cos 4 pi 10 to the power 40 into cos 2 pi 10 to the power 60. You have to find the bandwidth, transmitted power, total power and modulation efficiency. So you can see, you can rewrite this equation as, if you take 20 common, 20 into 1 plus 12 divided by 20 cos 2 pi 10 to the power 40 plus 16 divided by 20 cos 4 pi 10 to the power 40 into cos 2 pi 10 to the power 60. So you can see this equation and you'll get a feeling that this is your carrier, this is your message signal, two message signals. Okay, so mu 1 you can calculate, 12 divided by 20, that is 0.6. mu 2 you can calculate, it is 16 divided by 20, that is 0.8. this is 0.6. Now the bandwidth you can calculate, 2 into highest frequency of the message signal. So these are my message signals. Highest frequency is this guy, 2 into 10 to the power 4. Here the frequency is 10 to the power 4. Here 2 into 10 to the power 4 will be the frequency. So that is why 2 into 20 kilohertz. So that comes out 40 kilohertz. That is your answer. To calculate PT, total power, this is your PC 1 plus mu T square divided by 2, where PC is your 20 square divided by 2, this is the amplitude. Okay, PC square 20 square divided by 2, 1 plus mu T, which is 0.6 square plus 0.8 square divided by 2, which comes out to be 300 watt. Okay, eta you can calculate, mu T square divided by mu T square plus 2, where mu T, if you calculate, it comes out to be 1 upon 1 plus 2, that is 1 by 3, that is 33.33%. This is your answer, this is your answer, and this is your answer.